All right, can you see Bob with that camera?
No.
Where do you want him?
He's got to stand up.
All right, so as a lot of you know, this is Bob's last season. All right, and so what I wanted to do, Coach Thronson and I both wanted to do some cool stuff to thank him for all the years. So what we did, what I did, is I wrote him a letter. Coach Thronson did his own thing. And I'm going to read that letter. To all of you. So I was hoping Coach Montague was going to be here, because I had some good burns on him. And it was going to be awesome. So I guess I have to change my speech just a little bit. It's all right. And one thing before I start. In 1997, I was sitting at that table over there, and my friend Corey Bass bet me that I couldn't last a week in a wrestling room. And so I went to the wrestling room on the first day of practice, which was the very first day that he was head coach. Coach Board stepped down, and this was his very first day as head coach. And I was there. And I'm here on his very last day. And so it only made sense that, as you can tell with this screen down, that I make and I tell his story. All right, so this is a letter I wrote to you, Bob.
Don't make me.
I won't. All right, so it says, Dear Bob, all young men that have grown up into becoming old men know what I'm about to say is true. There are five or six men that come into a young man's life and turn into a mentor. These mentors show the young man what real strength is. The power of influence, the power of kindness, and most importantly, the power of sturdiness. And it goes without saying, you are one of the mentors in my life. It's impossible to describe the things that you've taught me in the last 25 years in just a few paragraphs. And so I've decided to share my top three Bob lessons. Lesson number one, if you pick the right partner, anything is possible. For example, if you pick the right practice partner, anything is possible. Like the way you chose Lenny Brew to be your practice partner. And he beat you up every day until the impossible happened and you became a national champion. Another example is, if you choose the right business partner, anything is possible. Like the way you chose Adam Thronson to be your business partner. And together you guys created 25 state placers, a third place team, and most importantly, fostered hundreds of young men into becoming excellent members of the community. And lastly, if you choose the right life partner, anything is possible. Like the way you chose Kathy to be your wife. And together you two have raised two wonderful boys, and you build a sustainable infrastructure that should keep our club taken care of for a very long time. Thank you for teaching me that life is a two-player game. And if you pick the right partner, anything is possible. That's the first lesson. And he said lesson number two tonight. Lesson number two, Bob taught me. I'm just a spoke in the wheel. In the 2018-2019 season, you chose me to lead the team in your absence and you made me head coach. And I quickly learned how hard it was to be the man. By me simply saying that being the head coach is a full-time, 40-hour-a-week job is a gross understatement. For me, it was more like being the head coach is a lifetime commitment. For you, your wife, Mommy, who needs to become the president of the club and needs to talk to all the parents. For your brother, who's going to be the announcer, a lifetime commitment. For your sister, who's going to run the admissions, A lifetime commitment for your kids, who's going to be at every single tournament and work all the tables. And a lifetime commitment to your friends, who are a bunch of old wrestlers that come in and beat up these high schoolers. And if you, Noah, took anything less than that oath, you, Noah, are going to fall, or going to fail, or even worse, just be mediocre. And that's what it takes to be head coach. So I want to thank you for showing me how to be a spoke in the wheel, how to trust other people, and trust that other people will do their jobs and get it done, and it all comes together in the end. And the third lesson Bob taught me: do cool things. Because we only get to play the game of life one time. Thank you. Thanks to you, Bob. Being on this wrestling team has allowed me to do so many not wrestling things. For example, I've fed the homeless. I've been in a parade. I've attended a huge picnic at a lake. I've traveled all over the Midwest. I've been stranded in a snowstorm. I brought my family to Universal Studios. I've been to Wisconsin Dells. I've been to a college wrestling match. I called bingo in a bar. I won a $10,000 raffle ticket. I got to see the WWF style wrestling match in our field house. I got to dress up like Hulk Hogan. And I got to give a kid the memory of a lifetime. I've been at a Super Bowl party that resulted in a broken couch.
We just fixed it.
I learned how to play craps. And I got to do all these things on a wrestling team. Thank you for teaching me that we only get to play the game of life one time. And so, why not try everything twice and do cool things? Thank you, Bob, for everything. Noah Glenn.
Dear Bob, it's hard to start a thank you letter or celebration letter when the person you're writing this to has been such a part of your life. Where's the time gone? I walked onto your patio in the spring of 1995 looking for a freestyle coaching job, and now 28 years later have come and gone. I am going to try and express to you how important you've been to this program and to me. You have established a standard of excellence in this program that few programs in the state can match. Since the first year I coached with you in the Mat Bandits, your mentality followed the mantra of never satisfied. And I remember you saying that. And even though it drove me crazy sometimes, I understood why. You were always searching for the way to get better, and that has shown in your results. Now, if you and I had an honest conversation, I know that you'd bring up 2004 and you'd bring up 2020, because both of those teams had legit shots at qualifying. But I would ask you to look at things another way. Before you came, our program had 6 conference titles. And since you have been the coach, you now have had 8 more. And you broke a 24-year gap in conference titles. Before you came, our program had 26 state place winners. Since you started, we have added 38. Before you started, we had 3 state champions. Since you started, we have added 7. We are a program that expects to be ranked in the top 12 year after year, as well as fighting for a conference and section title, and you leave this program with 486 career wins, a standard of excellence. On a personal note, I wish to express to you how much you have meant to me. You've shaped me into the coach I am today. We have laughed, traveled, fought, yelled, argued, celebrated, cried, lost, and won together. We have stayed in the same hotel rooms every time. Agreed and disagreed about lineups and matchups. We've served time together. We were pro wrestlers together. And you've been there for me through some of the most difficult times in my life. Whether it was a ride or a place to stay. You've been there for me. I can never repay you for what you have meant to me or done for me. All I can do is try to be for someone else what you've been for me, a loyal and trusted friend. I love you, brother. Now let's go play some golf.
This is a plaque that goes to a retiring coach who has coached for more than 35 years. He officially will have 40 years totally coaching. And I know we're about to play something, but ladies and gentlemen, Bob Adam.
Coon Rapids wrestling because I enjoy watching the wrestlers go beyond their expectations, perform at the highest of levels, and do things that they never thought they could do before.
You can tell your old man you'll do some largemouth fish in another town. You just got too much on your plate to bait and cast a line. You can always put a rain check in his hand till you can't. You can keep putting off forever with that girl whose heart you hold, swearing that you'll last someday further down the road. You can always put a diamond on her hand till you can. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can, till you can. There's a box of greasy parts sitting in the trunk of that 65, still waiting on you and your granddad to bring it back to life. You can always get around to fixing up that Pontiac till you can't. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can, till you can't. So take that phone call from your mama, just talk away, 'cause you'll never know how bad you wanna till you can't someday. Don't wait on tomorrow, 'cause tomorrow may not show. Say your sorries, your I love yous, 'cause man, you never know. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can, till you can. Yeah, if you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody,
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock.
Yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you can get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name.
Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame. Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers.
Be students, be teachers.
Be politicians, be preachers.
Be preachers.
Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
You can be a king, come hanging on your chest.
You can be a general, you can be the war. You can talk a jackal, banging on his back.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate your job and you can find your first step.
Took a look down a westbound road, right away I made my choice. Headed out to my big two-wheeler, I was tired of my own voice. Took a beat on the northern plains and just rolled that power on. Twelve hours out of Mackinac City, stopped in a bar to have a brew. Met a girl, we had a few drinks, and I told her what I decided to do. She looked out the window a long, long moment, then she looked into my eyes. She didn't have to say a thing. I knew what she was thinking. Never even said a word, we just walked out and got on that bank. And we rolled. And we rolled clean out of sight. Good to be.
me home to the grave.
Short, but that video was amazing. Noah, where's Noah? Thank you so much. A lot of memories. A lot of coaches. I've been blessed with great coaches, great assistants, great parents. And I can't thank everybody enough. I did want to say I'm not leaving. I'm just stepping back. Somebody else's turn. I know Coach Thronson has always wanted to be in running the show, and I'm sure he'll do a fantastic job. He certainly has the energy and loves the sport. He loves Coon Rapids, just as I have. The Lord works in mysterious ways. I'm not going to make it. When I was 13 years old, I was at the junior high. I fell off the high bar on the first day of practice and I broke both my wrists. Best day of my life. I decided the next year I wasn't going to do gymnastics, I was going to join wrestling. And Mr. Way had a Phi-Ed class where he had a wrestling unit, and I beat the guy that was on the A team at that time in eighth grade. And I thought, geez, I must be pretty good. This guy's been wrestling a few years, and it's my first year. So I went out for the sport of wrestling, and I fell in love with it ever since. I wrestled at Coon Rapids High School, and then I went to Augsburg College and had some success at Augsburg, and my head coach Jeff Swenson, who I feel is one of the best coaches in the United States. And I'm sure Coach Thronson and Coach Mandyke can attest to that as well. He asked me to coach after my senior year. He asked me if I would coach at Augsburg College, and I thought, okay, I'll give it a year, and 1 year turned into 10 years. I also coached in the Mat Bandit program for about 12 years. I then went to Centennial for 2 years and coached there. I then came to Coon Rapids and coached under my coach, Coach Board, for 3 years, and then took over the head coach position when Coach Board retired. I've been through 7 athletic directors here at Coon Rapids. My first year as the head coach, my wife and I put some money into the program. We only had about $600. And she allowed me to borrow the program some money because we needed new uniforms. And we sold pizzas, we sold steaks to reimburse us, etc. We had a concession stand over at Lions Park right over here. One night we used to make about $100 a week off the concession stand. One night I almost got mugged after closing the stand. It was dark. And I thought to myself, we can't do this anymore. This is crazy, the work we were putting in.
I started looking around for an alternative way to make money for our program. And I used to play softball for Scoops. And our team would go in there often, and I met the owner of the bar, and he was a graduate from Coon Rapids, so we knew each other pretty good. I asked him where all the money went for the pull tabs, and he said, well, they spread the money around for all kinds of things. I said, do you think they'd help us buy some uniforms for the middle school? Our middle school uniforms were 30 years old. And he goes, yeah, go ahead and ask them. So I did. I asked the gambling manager if they would give us some money, and they said yeah, and they gave us $5,000 for uniforms. About a month later, I called him up and said, okay, I got a bill for $5,000, almost $5,000. And he goes, oh, I'm sorry, we can't pay for it. I said, what do you mean you can't pay for it? I said, you said you could pay buy us uniforms. And so I told the owner, I said, hey, he promised to pay this bill, and now he's not paying it. So he called him up, got his side of the story, called me back and said, you're my new gambling manager. And that's how I fell into the charitable gambling. I had a couple parents who were laughing at me at some of our board meetings and said, Adams, are you still talking about this charitable gambling thing? And I shut my mouth and just went to work and started putting it together. And a few months down the road, I brought in a check for, I think it was $5,000 for the month. And I said, can I have permission to put this in the bank account? And of course, everybody voted yes. Since then, we've done pretty well. And I remember many, many years ago thinking, wow, I don't know if I can do this forever. I was coming home and auditing games all night long and into the morning, and I just knew that we couldn't give it up. My wife lost her job back then and stepped up and became my assistant, and has been the savior of our charitable gambling program. She has supported me 100%. She could be the volunteer of the year every year. She helps with everything. Our banquets, our tournaments, our perfect attendance, our awards, everything. She's been my biggest backer, so I would like to give a nice round of applause for my wife. Muffy, you've been a godsend to our program as well. Thank you so much. Watching that video, Noah, brings back so many memories. I guess some of my best memories were 7 kids in the state tournament in 2004. That's a record for our program. That was half the weights made it to the state tournament that year. 2 years ago, we had 6 kids go to the state tournament. Just a couple weeks ago, Noah invited me over to Scoops, and I was with the 2000 team, and we had so much fun that night. Every year I'm asked a question about our banquet booklet. It's about the poem that somebody wrote in 1995. And that poem has been a secret up until now. I wrote that poem. And that why I love being a Cardinal wrestler. And it's all stated right there. I'm most proud of my boys, who are both state champions. I'm proud of our team this year. Like I said, they battled. I believe next season is going to be a good one if we do what we have to do. It's been an honor and a privilege to be part of this program all these years. Thank you.